If we take a look here, we can actually classify different types of compounds as either being strong electrolytes, weak electrolytes, or non-electrolytes. So let's look at the strong electrolytes. Our strong electrolytes belong into three categories. First things first, we have our strong acids. Strong acids are considered strong electrolytes, so they break up completely when they're dissolved in water. Examples here, we have HCl, we have a blank, then we have HI. Now, if you take a look at your periodic table, you'll notice that chlorine and iodine are both in the same group number. Both of them are in group 7A. Take a look at your periodic table. What element is in between chlorine and iodine? It'll be Br. So HBr is considered a strong acid as well. HF is not considered a strong acid. It's actually considered a weak acid. It's because it possesses hydrogen bonding. You'll learn about that later on. But just realize, because of the hydrogen bonding it has present in it, HF is considered a weak acid. So HCl, HBr, HI so far. HNO3 is another strong acid. Then the last three will be H2SO4, HClO4, and HClO3. Those are considered your seven major types of strong acids. Now, the second type of strong electrolyte we can have are strong bases. Now, we're going to say strong bases fit into two major types of categories up to this point. Later on, when we learn more in-depth analysis on acids and bases, we're going to open up to more and more different types of acids and bases. For this point right now, this is all you really need to know when it comes to electrolytes. So for strong bases, group 1A metals, when they're combined with OH minus, H minus, O2 minus, or NH2 minus, they will be strong bases and they'll be considered strong electrolytes. Remember, what's the charge of group 1A ions? They're all plus 1. So we combine each of these with one of these ions. So Na plus OH minus, their charges just cancel out and you get NaOH. Here, the charges just cancel out, you get CSH. The two from here is going to move down here. The one from here is going to move over here. So this would be K2O. And then finally, you'd have LiNH2. So all of these are good examples of strong bases. Now, any one of these four ions could combine with any one of the group 1A metals to create a strong base. Now, the next one we have, group 2A metals. Here we're going to say calcium or lower, when they're combined with these same four ions, create strong bases. But what exactly do I mean by calcium or lower? Group 2A on our periodic table has beryllium, magnesium, and then calcium you have, strontium, and barium. I'm saying calcium and lower. So calcium, strontium, and barium. When they're with one of these guys, they create a strong base. All of them are in group 2A, so they're all plus 2. Okay, so if we combine some of them with some of these ions, just remember the two from here will move down here, the two from here will move over here, the two from here will move over here. So we get CaOH2, SrH2, Ba, brackets, NH2, 2. These are all common examples of strong bases from group 2A. Finally, we're going to say soluble ionic compounds are considered strong electrolytes. What do I mean in this section? Here, this is basically the ionic compounds that follow the solubility rules. For example, we're going to say that Na is a group 1A metal. Group 1A ions are soluble with whoever they're with. So I could have Na with NO3. This will break up into Na plus, plus NO3 minus. Breaks up fully into its ion, so it's a strong electrolyte. We could also have LiCl. Group 1A metal. Cl is soluble with everyone also, except for certain metals. So our three categories for strong electrolytes are strong acids, strong bases, and those that follow the rules for being soluble when we look at the solubility rules.